show number 598. My name is Larry Herbeck, Box Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show. I've got Laura with me. Hi, Laura.
Hello.
Good to see you over there.
Good to be here.
After you took a two-show hiatus, as we say in the business.
Did you cruise through the Panama Canal? I can only assume.
That sounds a lot more interesting than
what it is. Why would
South
you
Pacific?
Say that?
Just a nice
That's interesting because I know somebody who did that. Recently.
Really?
Yeah, that's why I'm like, that's really weird.
Small world. And the Panama Canal makes it smaller.
It's always fascinating how Jeff and I have found out how our worlds often collide.
Mm-hmm.
We share similar tastes in...
In really dumb arcana.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, welcome back, everybody. I want to thank you guys for downloading the show. I know you have a lot of things to choose from. This is one of the very few family-friendly gaming podcasts out there.
Oh.
I was doing a little bit of research. Yeah, there's a few, but generally it's we try to run a pretty clean show, so you can listen to it with the kids in the car.
Exactly.
Or
I showered this week. I'm going to be real clean.
Well, you are always born family friendly. What a week! What a couple weeks!
Yes.
I was in Florida.
You've been all over the place.
Oh boy, haven't I ever! I'll tell you, I was in the lovely state of Florida, Jeffrey.
Yeah, there's a man from Florida. He has a Twitter account. It's accurate.
And I believe you know this Florida man quite well.
There are things that I've done pre-Twitter that probably would have qualified.
Yeah. I don't know about you, Laura, but I had a pretty reckless youth, and I'm glad that Twitter and Snapchat and the rest of these recording devices were not around.
To document
and stay with you forever and ever and ever and ever.
Kids these days.
I will say, anyone who thinks kids today, they got it so easy. It's can you imagine if your entire life had been recorded? I mean, it is now. We're recording right this second.
Right.
That's true.
But we at least got to have a few precious years.
A modicum of privacy.
Yes.
Of privacy. Yeah.
Anyway. All right, so here we go. We're going to get into what we're playing, what we're doing, how we're doing. We got to name the game. I don't know if you listened to the show last week, Laura.
What happened?
But I did have Chris Charla do a name the game because he was. Well, it was an ID at Xbox game, and he came in with a stack of ID at Xbox games to give away. So he's like, "Hey, can I do name the game?" And I'm like, "It was kind of awkward moment off the air," and I'm like, "Okay, so." That's
all
okay.
Right.
He really, you don't want to see a grown man beg like that.
Yeah, yeah. He was, because he was a big fan of the show. And I said, well, Laura usually does it.
I'm sure he did it well.
But she's not
I'm
here.
Sure
okay.
He did it well.
Anyway, but we'll do that later on. Do name the game. We got a brand new winner and a brand new prizes, brand new everything, brand new show. Can you smell that, Jeffrey? Can you smell the plastic on the show?
It's can I peel it off, Larry? Please. I love doing
it. Nothing better than a good show. All right. Let's get into what we're playing.
It's almost like when Lara's not on the show.
Yeah, I know.
It gets stupid, but you've been gone so long. I don't know how to get the professionalism back.
You know, we talked a little bit about it last week. I think we did, Jeffrey. Yeah, we did with Chris. But I want to make sure you picked up on this, Laura. I know that I talked about a month and a half ago about the whole Dr. Pepper scenario here at Microsoft.
You talked about
the
it on
Diet
the show.
Dr. Pepper, right?
Yes, I've seen the saga.
So this is it has come to a close, a successful and happy conclusion. I have closure.
You can make it. You can fight City Hall.
I do. I did. I just sent email to the dining services people and said, this Diet Dr. Pepper thing. Well, I sent you the letter.
Yes,
do you remember?
You sent me a letter.
You sent
and
one of them.
Sent me the results.
Yeah.
And I was like, congratulations, Larry.
That's right.
You've moved
that
mountains.
That was one of the letters because I sent a few of them, but that was one of them. Anyway, but enough about that.
But you have moved mountains. And it's back.
It is back.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
Better than ever.
Do what you can do. All right. What are we, Laura, what are you playing? What have you been up to?
So, in my time off, from the show, I've played a few games.
Yeah, we talk about that for a minute?
Okay.
There's only one person that can take annual leave, and his name is Graham.
Yes, true.
He's probably on it right now.
Okay,
exactly. Yeah.
Actually, I just had a meeting move for Monday because it's a bank holiday, and I'm like, of course it is. Of course it is.
Move to the UK. You don't have to work 40 hours a week.
That'd be great.
Well, I don't know what they do over there. They have a different view. Anyway, go ahead.
They're not doing it wrong.
Yeah, apparently. Yeah, you know what? You're absolutely right, Jeffrey. Something's doing it wrong.
Cool. So I have been playing a few ID Xbox games.
Go on.
The first one, we had him on the show the last time I was on the show, the creator of Thimbleweed Park.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
And
absolutely.
I've been diving into that. I'm probably about 6 or 7 hours in.
Yeah, we if you go back, you can actually listen to that. It's Ron Gilbert, Thimbleweed Park. It's show number 595.
Exactly. And it is super fun.
Did you play point and clicks? But they were past that stage when you were getting into computers, right?
I did play a lot of Monkey Island.
Oh, okay. So okay.
I was a little young, but right when computers were getting big and we all want to play computer games.
Was this before or after was like your computer connected to the internet?
Before.
Really? Okay, yes. So there was no issues.
No.
Okay.
I just remembered one that I played, and I was way too young to be playing at the time. So the very first point-and-click game.
Don't say it, please.
I'm going to bring it on back around. It's Leisure Suit Larry.
I know.
And this was a game, I think my uncle who gave it to me. So like when we were like, I don't know, I was maybe like 10.
I'm sorry, Laura. He just T-boned your section.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry, but it just brought it flooding back. I think this
let's finish this thought.
I don't have a therapist, but
It's us right here. It's group therapy.
When I was 10, my uncle got us a computer and a bunch of games and had like Family Feud and Jeopardy and whatever.
Oh,
it was an 8088. I learned DOS. And one of the games was Leisure Suit Larry on a CGA 4-color monitor. And
he let you play it?
I don't think he realized.
Oh.
Either he had no idea what the game was about or thought it was funny. I beat that game. And I learned a lot. In fact, it really probably shaped my formative years.
You know what? That explains a lot of what I know about you publicly and personally.
And my viewpoint of people named Larry.
Yes, exactly. Thank you. Sorry about that. Usually I'm the one that interrupts, and I've been trying to stop doing that. So
I'm the worst.
On behalf of Jeffrey, I apologize. Go ahead, my friend.
All right, bringing it back to Thimbleweed Park.
Mm-hmm.
So it is really fun. I am super enjoying it because it is very, very funny. Yes, Larry.
Were you an X-Files fan back in the day? Because it has a little bit of X-Files-esque to it.
It does, doesn't it? There are two partners who are going to investigate a murder, and they go to a town called Thimbleweed Park and try and figure out what happened.
Yeah, point and click.
Exactly. And there are a few side adventures where you meet a character and then you play that character's backstory, which is super fun and pretty funny. And again, the humor is right up my street because it's nerdy humor, computer game humor, all kinds of things. So if you're a fan of Monkey Island and any kind of point and click adventure, try this out. Try it out.
All right.
It's super fun.
Thimbleweed Park.
Yep. Currently stuck, which is surprising because I usually don't get stuck, but I am trying to find a way through a particular puzzle. It's about 6 hours in.
In Thimbleweed Park. Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you want me to
where the agents get separated?
If you want me to connect you with Ron, just let me know. He may not tell you. He may say, screw it, you're on your own. That's what the game's all about.
Yeah, I'm worried that I screwed it up. Because one of the agents gets trapped, and that agent has something that I need to solve a different part of the puzzle.
Yeah.
And I can't get that agent out.
Well, you know, that reminds me, you know, Ron and I talked about that in the interview on Show 595 about, you know, we've seen this over time, like back in the day, like you described when you were growing up playing the game, and I've never finished or played Leisure Suit Larry, Jeffrey, so I don't know how.
You're lost.
I mean, I remember seeing it.
Very educational.
But there's certain points, games back in the 80s and 90s where you could screw up your game.
Yeah.
And you would have to roll back or start over.
Yes.
So I don't know if it's possible in Thimbleweed Park, but that's an old school game mechanic, as it were, right?
It was. So I hope that's not the case.
Yeah.
Where I can somehow solve my way out of this one, but I need to, you know, maybe talk to someone and see how I might solve that one
because
I'm kind of stuck.
Okay,
so we'll see.
So if you have any ideas or it sounds like you may know where Laura is, hit her up on Twitter. They can find her at.
If you have any tips, hit me up at Laura Lollipop.
Thank you.
On Twitter.
Yeah, but you know, just make sure you tag it as spoiler or something like that. But don't
try not to spoil.
Yeah, try not to spoil. So
say, I was similarly stuck. Here's what we do.
Yeah, just point her in a direction. Don't lead her. Okay, show her how to fish. Don't fish for her.
Thank you.
As it were.
Very good. And I played another game.
Yes,
it's on Windows. It's called Loot Rascals. Have you guys heard of this one?
No.
No.
It is a isometric dungeon crawler.
Oh.
But it's different. It's actually a turn-based dungeon crawler. So the world is segmented in hexagons, and when you move a hexagon, then the rest of the world.
What's it
moves.
Called? Loot.
Loot Rascals.
Rascals. I'm looking it up right now. Have I heard of it? Go ahead. Oh, it's new.
Mm-hmm. So again, when you move a tile, the rest of the world moves. So there's, you know, baddies that you have to go kill, and when you do kill a baddie, you get a card, and this card is how you increase your defense or increase your attack. Mm-hmm. And the metagame of this is to arrange your cards in such a way that gives you more bonuses. And so that's what I really love about this game is the card arrangement.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, a card might say, does double damage if it's in an even slot. And you have to, you know, fill it out in a grid, and the grids have numbers. And so you have to put that one in an even slot. And then there's another card that might say, you know, +2 to defense if it's in the bottom row. And there's all different kinds of rules that you have to follow to get the most out of it.
What is the game like? It sounds like it's this. I'm having trouble getting my. I mean, I'm looking at what it's about, but how would you describe the game to somebody in terms of what's the elevator pitch for this game?
A turn-based isometric dungeon crawler.
With cards.
With cards.
Okay, there you go.
With card bonuses.
Card bonus, okay.
So the loot is the cards.
Oh boy, there it is.
Yep.
The loot.
So every
game
kill,
has loot these days, Larry. Yeah. Your favorite game.
I know, Overwatch.
Of like the last year.
It's
has,
got crates.
Yes,
I know, crates.
I bought $10 worth yesterday to get an intro.
You know what else has loot is the Gwent beta. I'm playing the Gwent beta.
Oh, nice.
It has loot.
Well, it has kegs, and then you open up the kegs.
What are in kegs?
Cards.
Okay, you get more cards.
More cards, yeah. So,
kegs.
In fact, I just did a video of that last week. You look for that soon.
It looks really good. I've been playing it on PC here and there, and it's just, I enjoyed Gwent. I played it a lot in the early game of The Witcher, and at some point I just needed to beat the game.
Yeah, exactly.
But they really like made the most of it,
yeah.
I would say.
Anyway, sorry.
Yeah, so that's super fun.
My Larry interrupt us again. I apologize.
Okay. It's just, that's your nature.
Yeah, it's rude.
It's your show. It's on the
No, team. It's our show. This is group therapy. That's right, you know, that's what I'm going to rename the podcast, group therapy.
Yes.
There you go.
Right.
This way we can probably make it tax deductible.
Right, exactly. And you, the listeners, can make it tax deductible too. It's mental health.
It's volunteering. Yeah.
It's mental health.
Oh my goodness.
All right, so you're playing that. What else you got?
Just talking about mental health, I watched Shutter Island the other night. Have you seen it?
Cutter Island?
Shutter.
Shutter Island. Oh.
It's an old movie.
You know this because you pointed this out when we were flying into PAX East.
When you fly into Boston, you fly over some of those islands where they shot some of the exteriors.
For
Shutter Island, yeah.
Leo
the Leo DiCaprio one, yeah.
Yeah.
It's funny because Jeff and I were sitting next to each other, remember? Mm-hmm. And I said, "This is exactly what I said."
That's right.
So funny.
There's the island.
Yeah, like, hey, look down there. And Jeff's like, what?
Oh, man, what a terrifying movie.
Because if you remember correctly, he was too busy not throwing up to remember that. So I'm actually surprised.
By the time we got to Shutter Island, my cookies were not tossed.
Anyway, what brought you to that?
You mean why did I watch
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, what's how just?
I don't know. Someone said it was a good movie that I should watch, so we watched it.
You want to watch a great movie?
I do.
The Third Man.
The Third Man, not Birdman.
Third Man. One,
third.
Two, third man. It is a Orson Welles film.
Okay.
It is. I think it's got like a Metacritic 100.
Really?
It is unbelievable.
Is it out on like Netflix?
Oh, it's on Netflix. It's pretty much on all the major streaming platforms. Seriously, go. It's one of those where I'm like, okay, this is pretty. And I watched it. I couldn't stop watching it.
Really?
That's all. That's all I don't want to say anymore. Have you seen it?
I have not.
Okay. This is anybody who has seen this, you'll agree with me. It's phenomenal. It holds up.
To my list of things to watch.
So, I'm sorry. Was there a story with Shutter Island? Are you just telling me what we
were? No, you were talking about mental health.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's right. That's right. That's right.
Don't take me down that rabbit hole.
Yeah.
That's really terrifying.
Well, you know, it's interesting. We're talking about mental health because in the. Well, never mind. I was going to talk about my days on the movie set with Kevin Bacon, but you don't want to hear that.
I think we do.
No, you.
I'm only one degree away.
That's.
I'm only one degree away. Too.
When we shot Sleepers, it was at a boys' home / mental institution. It was a very very dark film.
Yeah,
I didn't. That was I didn't get at that
'90s, right?
At that point in my career, I didn't have the ability to pre-read the script, so I had no idea that it was as dark as it was.
And you were. Quiet boy number two or something?
No, I was. I am scorekeeper at the football game.
Oh, okay.
Because I you've never heard this story.
I feel like
we had to go in. I was being cast as a guard because I had a certain look back then because I was a sturdy young New Englander.
Sturdy.
And I please don't read that, Laura. You're gonna get disturbed.
Oh, I've seen it. It's a very disturbing movie.
We went in and they're like, hey, we need X number of guards. You're going to be a guard for this scene. What part of the field do you want on? And I basically said, I want to keep score because I knew, regardless of what the camera angle was, there was only going to be one scorekeeper.
Yeah.
Right? So I couldn't say left side, right side, you know, this. So that's why, and I think I'm only in there for all of maybe 120 frames, if that.
Mm-hmm. That's almost as much as the E.T. documentary.
That's right. Which was, by the way, it's 3-year anniversary this week.
What? Oh no.
Somebody sent me an email that was three years ago this week. You and I were in the middle of the Alamogordo, New Mexico.
Yeah.
Time flies,
right.
Jeffrey.
That was fun. That was a lot of fun.
Wow.
Right?
3 years.
3 years. In fact, I still don't think those clothes have lost their stench.
No. I've never been dirtier.
Yeah. All right. All right. Mental health. Laura, what else are you playing?
Okay. And the only other thing I'll talk about is I did a lot of traveling of my time off and played a bunch of mobile games. And one particular mobile game has kept me coming back. And it's called Balls, B-A-L-L-Z.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a combination of like Brick Breaker, where you're trying to break brick to the top. And I don't know, I guess like Snood, where you only get to shoot one ball. And when you break a brick, the ball will bounce around. And once it hits at the bottom, you know, yeah, that turns over, but you can get more Balls to Follow.
Now, this is not that I'm looking. There was a fighting game in 1994 out on Super Nintendo and the 3DO. It's not that.
No. And I feel like there's an energy drink that I had at like at Roscoe's in LA one time.
Probably called that. Probably Balls.
Oh, you might be right.
How do you know energy drink names?
She knows her way around.
My God.
I work with computer programmers.
Fair point. That's right. You are.
They carry around power drinks all the time.
All right. But you don't carry on a power drink.
No, because that would probably kill me.
That would arrest you.
That would make my heart stop.
Yeah, right.
Too much caffeine.
Okay.
Bounce off the wall.
So balls.
Be the end of me. Yes. Super addicting. If you need something on an airplane or on a bus, try it out.
Why don't we link to that so people, addicting. We don't, you know, in our family friendly, you know, yes. oeuvre, we don't see people searching for balls.
By the way, I love how we talked about family friendly and Jeff decided to steer it right into the gutter with Leisure Suit Larry. Can I just point that out?
Look, I take both hands in the wheel from the passenger seat and I drive right into the ravine.
Yank it over. Yeah, sorry about that. Balls.
You're the one.
What?
You really gave it the Rod Roddy on that one. What does he win, Rod? Balls.
All right. Never a dull one here.
All right. Never a dull one.
All right. I'm looking into that. I found it.
That's mm-hmm. it for me.
Please all right. don't.
Move on.
I am playing. What am I playing, Jeffrey? I'm playing, of course, Overwatch.
What?
Surprise.
Playing Zelda. Oh, wait,
we want to dive in. We haven't really talked about the current like mode du jour of Overwatch.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, which we haven't gotten you the... We got you the achievement.
No, right? I have not beaten it yet.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're playing a little... I'm playing Overwatch, of course, with the crew as much as we can. Laura, you're always
it's
welcome.
Still,
thank
so
you.
Good. I'm back into it again. I was playing during a meeting today.
You're playing Overwatch
what?
During
you're
a meeting?
Playing during
I had a meeting?
Meeting?
I had a meeting with some folks in Asia, and so it was really early in the morning, our time, and I knew I was not going
Winky
to
face.
Be... Yes. Mm-hmm. And so the meeting was not easy mode, and... And I knew I wasn't going to have anything that I was going to have to say
oh, that's
for like
right,
the first
you were,
half
you
an hour.
You were from home. I'm like, where
I was
you
at home, so I was like, man, I had a heck of a game on mute.
Good
like,
for
when
you.
You turn your mind off
yeah.
and you just play.
Yeah.
I had 28 kills with Hero 76.
Playing, so
wow.
I'm playing
76.
I'm playing that. I'm playing Zelda. I'm still churning through Zelda. That's my mobile game.
Still so good.
How far are you in?
I don't want to give too much away, but I finished the four major things you mm-hmm. need to do, and that's all I want to say about that. But I don't want it to end. Mm-hmm. I had the weird.
Are you about to go into?
Well, I wanted to tell you about a bizarre quest that I had, but it's not really family friendly. I mean,
I think we're gonna have the little E next to.
Did we flush that
episode.
Down the toilet? So,
yeah.
So there's this one quest, Laura, where you have to do something, mm-hmm. and there's this professor, this individual who's like, I don't believe you're Link. Because Link has scars and tattoos. And I'm standing there like, what am I going to do? Oh, I have to take off all my clothes.
Oh, no. Yeah.
I did that one.
Right? Yeah. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
So
prove
is it
that you are Link?
Yes. So I'm Link all right. So I'm playing that. Playing Voodoo Vince. Jeffrey's mm-hmm. been playing that. Laura's
I beat
been playing,
it.
You did?
Yeah. That game really clicked with me.
Yeah.
And like just anytime I had a free moment, I would sit down and play it. And it was probably a good 9 hours to 9-10 hours to beat it.
Mm.
Definitely a good value for, I think it's $14.99.
Yeah.
And it was really fun.
Yeah. I played that and I was just having, you're right. It's just, it was so good to go back and hit that up again. Played a little bit of City Skylines, which is out. Mm. Clicker Heroes. You should check that out, Jeffrey. I think you'll love that.
Okay.
What is Clicker Heroes?
All you do is press A and you get achievements.
Yes. It's press A.
Downloading now.
We talked about I'm playing Gwent the Card Game. So I'm, you know, still churning through that. A little bit of Fallout Shelter. There's just a lot going on right now. There's a lot
sure
to play. And I'm just and then we're not going to talk about that other game you and I were talking
what?
About last night.
Why not?
Because I haven't played yet.
Well,
I
barely played
up.
As well. Okay, then we'll talk about
let's,
that
let's
next switch. Week.
Yeah.
I would say outside of that, in my house, the big game right now is Overcooked.
Oh, yes.
Because we're always at each other's throats. So now we're at each other's throats, for cause. Like,
should we?
I can't believe
throats.
You.
Should we play that on the show here? Maybe at PAX?
It's
oh gosh,
really
amazing.
It's really fun. And it's really like, the amount of
Well, we
yelling.
Need a fourth. Who's a fourth? Because you have to play with four, right?
No, you can play with three.
Okay.
Ron Gilbert.
Okay.
I'm sure you can come right. back. We can talk right. about it.
We'll
give
get
you the answer.
Well, you know what? Maybe for the, I'm thinking about this. Maybe for this PAX, we'll hire a real psychologist to come in and give us group therapy.
Oh, my goodness.
Right.
Wow.
I know. It is an hour. So that, and then I've still been playing through Zelda, like you, and Horizon Zero Dawn, which is a fun game. So
have you finished your four things in Zelda?
No. I've only done two of those things. Mm-hmm. But it's just so much fun to just wander around and say, hey, what's at the top of that mountain? And oftentimes there's something really cool.
I think I described it on the show earlier, right? It's the game that just says yes.
Yes, that's true.
Right. Can I get struck by lightning? Yes, you can. Can I go fishing? Yes, you can. Can I cook this? Yes, you can.
Actually, I'm on an island right now that I sailed to.
Yes.
And they took everything away from me. So I'm trying to figure out.
Ooh, I'll tell you how to do that. You want?
I know there's like a workaround where if I'd backed up the save, I could have like stashed my stuff somewhere.
Right.
But right now I'm just trying to figure it out. Okay. I'll let you know if I get stuck.
Yeah. I had a really fun time on that particular quest. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was just a lot of fun. Yeah. Anyway.
Lots of fun things happening.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Do we want to hit the news or what do you want to do?
Well, what are you playing? We kind of talked about what I'm playing. We didn't really go through. I guess we kind of did.
We're playing the same thing.
Yeah, we are playing the same thing.
Especially, right. I'm like so back on the Overwatch train right now.
Dude, do you want to play later?
Yeah.
We'll play tonight?
Yeah, still.
Okay.
Yeah.
Easy mode. By the way, have you seen D.Va? Apparently you play, is it Heroes of the Storm? What do you play?
Yes, it's Heroes of the Storm has, I think, a D.Va and a Lucio skin.
Do you mean the D.Va skin?
No. It's the police.
Yes.
It's like a Korean police.
I emailed a friend of mine at Blizzard. I'm like, must have now.
Well, so Jeff Kaplan, who does, you see him in the videos.
Jeff, yeah.
Yeah. I know of him.
Yeah.
But he, so many people want that. And they're like, well, what if I'm not playing Heroes of the Storm? So they did commit to, those will show up on Overwatch in the game, with, you know, in some capacity later.
In the future. Yeah, that's such a good, anyway.
Yeah.
All right, let's go through the news, and then we got some other stuff to talk about.
So I don't know if you saw this. We sort of like a couple months in advance, we tend to know things, and we'll see like on a calendar, oh, this announcement goes out this date, this announcement goes out that date. And I remember seeing a few weeks ago or a few months ago, something that said like Forza Horizon 3 Hot Wheels expansion.
I actually stopped a meeting and said, wait a minute, what?
Yeah, well, Hot I don't know. Wheels. I just, Lead seeing the words Hot Wheels, it just was like, okay. Whatever, I get some Hot Wheels cars. And then I saw the trailer, which we released this week. Mm-hmm. And that was a stop the presses moment where it's like, oh my God. I don't know if you, have you seen this trailer, Laura? Mm-hmm. It's so good.
Did you have Hot Wheels as a kid?
Yeah,
And you had the orange tracks?
Yes.
Did you like set them up through your house, like through the living room and stuff?
Yes, I did.
Yes, you did. Yeah, you did.
Hot Wheels.
So if you haven't seen this, and I'll link to it, but imagine the Hot Wheels set you may or may not have had as a kid.
Including the orange track.
Yes, and loop-de-loops and all this stuff as a playable space within
Forza Horizon 3
with Hot Wheels cars, and it just looks great. So I'm going to link to that,
super
and
awesome.
You definitely want to watch that. That definitely got a lot of attention this week. Also getting a lot of attention this week, another trailer, Call of Duty World War II was revealed. Now available, of course, for pre-order on Xbox One. It'll be coming early this November.
It's going to play great on Scorpio.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't even think about that.
Mm-hmm.
Trailer looks great. It looks super intense. So you'll definitely want to take a look at that, and I'll be happy to link to that as
Please
well.
Please do.
And as far as new releases... Big one this week is one that I think I'm too chicken to be playing, and that is Outlast 2.
Why?
Well, it's a scary game.
Yeah, but you like your scary games.
You do.
I kind of do.
You played Resident Evil.
I did, but I didn't finish it because I was too scared.
Me too.
It was really freaking frightening. Going into that first person mode makes a huge difference.
Agreed.
Having played like all of the previous Resident Evils,
right.
This one is one that I didn't. Or that I didn't get that far into. Another big release this week would be Sniper Ghost Warrior 3. Very different than Sniper Elite 4, which took place during World War II. This is a sort of a future-looking
game. You and I played that.
Mm-hmm.
But if you like sniping. And then something that if you had Halo Wars 2, if you pre-ordered that, a specific version of that, you would have already had this. But if you didn't, Halo Wars Definitive Edition is now available for Xbox One. So this is a redone version, an improved version of the original Halo Wars. I played through this one, which was a lot of fun.
Yes.
I've never done it the first time. And just two quick more notes. One is Siberia 3 is now available for Xbox One. That's a long-running series that goes back to like the mid-90s, I want to say.
Really? That long?
And then Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite is now available for pre-order and pre-download. It's not hitting until September, but I'm just excited for that one. You're not?
No, I'm going through the mental index of E3. Mm-hmm. And all the stuff we've got coming up at E3. So that was the blank stare. I was actually decrypting the encrypted part of my brain. That was the that was that look.
Is that with that whirring and yeah. sound and the smoke coming out of the ears?
All right, so those are some of the news headlines.
Just a handful.
Hey, here's a little tip. You want a little tip, Laura?
Of course.
So we are in the process of rolling out on Xbox Live custom gamer pictures, personal really? Ones.
Awesome.
So right now it's to the Xbox Insider program, but here's a tip. Mm-hmm. Okay. If you go download the Xbox beta, the Xbox app that's beta app on Windows 10. Mm-hmm. So in the Windows 10 store, you have to have Windows 10. And in the Windows 10 store, there's two different versions of the Xbox app. There's a really release one and then there's the beta. Mm-hmm. Just search for Xbox beta, download that. And you can change your gamer picture in there, which will go right over the service. So did you notice I changed my gamer picture?
I did.
You did?
I didn't know that you didn't have to be in the Insider program to do it.
That is the tip.
That is the tip.
So you can go in there and change it. Now, I will say this, to prepare yourself, make sure it is 1080 by 1080. And a lot of people are saying, why does it need to be that big? Because we're making sure that everything's going to look good on Scorpio later mm-hmm. this year. So mm-hmm. 1080, what are you going to have?
That's a good question.
Oh, I know the picture you should have. The one that you showed me once of you.
Oh, really?
Yes. You know which one I'm talking about?
Yeah. So. And am I in Texas regalia?
Yes, and you're with your hat and all of that stuff.
That'd be a good one.
You should customize your picture.
Or maybe the lollipop that I made myself.
Lollipop one, or maybe it's just a lollipop, right?
Yeah.
Anyway, Jeff did his, which is a selfie.
Yeah.
Which I'll is, I don't,
boring. What?
I don't do selfies.
It wasn't a selfie.
That's
it was,
right.
It was a screenshot. From when we were on stage at PAX.
Was that our show or was that?
That was our show.
That was our show, okay.
Yeah, so I just took I went back, watched the archive version.
Yes.
And then I just took a couple freeze frames. It's hard to get a good one, so I look stupid in all of them, but I just took one. I'll switch it later.
Okay, that's fine. Anyway, so that's my hot tip. If you want to change your gamer picture now, anybody, mm-hmm. as long as you have Windows 10 and go download the free Xbox
I'll link out to that.
Yeah,
to
and the way you can tell you have the beta app is when you open the app. It'll, first of all, you download the beta, but when you open the app, it'll say Xbox beta in the title bar. Mm-hmm.
That's a good tip.
So it's pretty straightforward. Thanks but it's coming to everybody later this year. So, all right, we're hustling along a little bit of shows. We got a little bit of a time crunch, but we've got a name the game.
Is it name the game time?
If you're ready, I'm ready.
I am ready.
Hold on. Jeff, are you ready?
Oh, never been
Dear
more ready.
Listener, are you ready? Because Laura, are you ready? Why don't you go ahead and fire it?
All right. This is name the game from last time. So that was Name the Game from last week, and it was Voodoo Vince. Pretty easy one, dun, I imagine. Dun, 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 dun. Exactly. All right, the
wah,
winner.
Wah, wah, wah.
Would you like to know who has won?
Why, of course. I, you know, more importantly, I think all the listeners want to know who won.
The winner is Bernard from Antioch, California.
Bernard!
Congratulations, Bernard.
Congrats.
You have a bunch of prizes.
And oh, yeah?
No kidding. These are a bunch of
No kidding. A bunch of prizes.
At ID Xbox titles.
So all right, Laura.
Thanks to Chris Charla for covering the
name. He always helps us out because there's just so many. You know, there are over 500 games on ID at Xbox,
really?
Right? Yep.
Over 500.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, listen to the show last week. You know that.
Oh, my goodness. All right, prizes.
Go.
Bernard, you have won a copy of Voodoo Vince.
Yes.
Lost Grimoires, Stolen Kingdom, which is a new ID Xbox title. Deformers, a new ID Xbox title. Outlast 2, which Jeff just mentioned.
Frightening.
And Play at Your Own Risk.
Little Nightmares, which is a new Bandai Namco title.
I think that's also really scary as well.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Just kind of. Little scream.
Depending on what you're into, this may or may not be like the best or worst prize pack.
And that's not all.
Whoa.
Bernard, you also win an Xbox wireless controller, the Recon Tech Special.
Is that where that nice? I knew that was off my desk. Is that where we're giving it to Bernard?
Yes.
Well, congratulations. I can't think of a better person to have it, so.
There you go, Bernard. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Bernard. And that means that you, dear listener, are going to get ready for another Name the Game, which is a weekly feature we do on the show. It's very simple. We play a sound clip from an Xbox game. It can be any type of game. There's going to be a clip here. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's easy. Sometimes it's not.
That's true.
And you send us an email and tell us what you think it is. So why don't we roll the clip, Laura, and then you can give away you can give out the email addresses
sounds
on the other
good.
Side.
All right,
ready?
Right. Here is Name the Game for this week. Thank you. So that was Name the Game for this week. Like Larry said, if you think you know what game those sounds are from, it's super easy to enter this game. All you have to do is send us an email.
Yeah.
Email lollipop@xbox.com and ccmajor@xbox.com and tell us what game that is.
Yeah, don't enter on Twitter, Snapchat, that's Facebook. Right. And we got to have an email so that we can put all the correct answers into a virtual hat.
And then pull it a random
And then R&D parentheses something. I don't know. I don't remember what the...
That was really good.
Thank you. Thank
yeah,
you.
You know a little bit there.
And a little, just enough code to
be dangerous.
To be bug infested. So, anyway, thank you, Laura. Thank you for that. Right. Good luck to everybody for Name the Game. Indeed. We'd love to have you for show number 598, which is this one right here. Jeff, what are you reading over there? You've got this intense look on your face.
I'll tell you in a minute, but you'll be excited. It's total just office stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll talk about that later. All right, we're gonna wrap the show up. We're running out of time here. I know you, dear listener, are not, but we are. We've got a lot coming up in the next few weeks. We have E3. We're getting ready for E3.
It's crazy. Coming up soon.
Coming up very soon. We've got a busy summer leading up to launch. I'm working on some really cool stuff that I can't talk about yet. I'm always working on cool stuff.
You always are.
This is really, really cool. So doing that. Do you want to talk about any fun stuff? Talking about any technology gadgets and or otherwise? I got a couple things.
You have a couple gadgets?
Well, this
we always
is
have the funnest gadgets.
Well, this sounds weird, okay. And I tweeted this out over the weekend. Jeff knows what I'm going to talk about. I'm going to talk about my water flow in my bathroom.
Okay.
So I was really bothered because I travel the world, and I always take like design cues and ideas from the different places I stay, whether the hotels and what have you. And I noticed I really don't like the aerated water in my house, and apparently. There's this thing called the laminar flow, which is a physics where it basically takes all the water molecules and lines them up in a straight line, so it comes out as a pure stream.
Really?
Yeah, so I bought some of these on Amazon.
Is this for the shower? Or this for
it's just for the hand wash, the basins in the bathroom. And anyway, so I bought a couple of those and popped them in. It's a 10-second unscrew, and you're done. Anyway, so I learned all about fluid dynamics this past weekend.
So how's your water?
It's great. I love
coming
it.
Out straight?
And nice and quiet, too, because you don't realize how much that aerated water is noisy.
So where does the aeration come in?
I think it's being, Jeff had the same exact question, and I don't have I'm not a plumber, so I don't know. But it's somehow introduced in the filter that's in there, the existing filter.
Oh, that's in the tap.
Yeah, that's in the tap. So anyway, that's
and then this thing just straightens them all back out.
Yes,
again.
Yes.
With all this plumbing talk, I think we're back to a clean broadcast.
We can talk about washlets. And then, so anyway, so that was really about it. I'm working on a couple other new gadgets and things I'm working on, but I'm not ready to talk about those yet.
Can I talk about my TV?
Yeah, I don't. You I well,
hear you, about your TV.
Yeah, why don't you tell us about your television?
I joined the 4K revolution.
Did
you get a color
TV?
Did you get a color TV?
I got a new color TV from Color Time. Yeah, it's a Samsung KS8000. I was looking at a few different models. I really like the look of the LG. There's a LG 860 or something like that, and which is an OLED, and it's amazing looking, and one of the best TVs ever made according to CNET. But it's also $3,000. So cross referencing, how can I play a game that has great response time for games? Has HDR, so I can take advantage of the Xbox One S now. Has 4K, so I can take advantage of 4K gaming with Scorpio. And I ended up with the Samsung KS8000. It's beautiful.
And I'll just say this, Laura. I got to share this with you.
Okay.
We're playing Overwatch last night. I hear this, and again, the stream of obscenities.
Oh, no.
Apparently, the TV decided to shut itself off so in the middle of a multiplayer game.
That. And I was having a heck of a game.
And I was on fire.
I literally was on fire in the game, and we were pressing the point. We were on Route 66.
Yep.
And we ended up winning that one, right?
But
it was harder than it needed to be.
Because you just decided.
At a crucial point, the TV shot off.
Oh, no.
So there's that. So you're hearing the full unpart. I still love the TV.
Right.
I would like to think maybe I sat on a remote somewhere.
I had this problem with my Samsungs where I think I mentioned this where we're playing and it's like, I'm going to shut off in 30 seconds, 29, 20. I'm like, why are you doing this? But this didn't even give you a pop-up. It's like, later.
Yeah. Maybe I should look for a firmware update or something like that.
I'm not going to judge you.
Yeah. Anyway.
Well, that's good. New TVs are always fun.
It is. I'm ready.
HDR, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can.
So Mass Effect looks really good in it, and a few other titles.
Force is going to look phenomenal.
Oh, yeah. Well, Horizon 3 already does.
Yeah. So there you go with that. Anything else, Laura, before we wrap up?
So when does the Hot Wheels pack come out? Have they announced it?
May 9th, I think. Yeah, yeah. I think it's May 9th. Wow.
Awesome. I'm looking forward to that.
Really?
That should be really fun.
Okay. Did you have a favorite Hot Wheels?
Hot Wheels.
You know, I told them, and this, please, don't take this the wrong way, Laura, because I made this, I was talking with the guys in the production we're working on this week on Xbox, and if Mattel really wanted to make it a Hot Wheels pack, it would have been cool if they put in like a Barbie camper. Right, like this little square, you know, it handles really poorly.
Well, my favorite Hot Wheels car growing up was a Renault Le Car.
Right.
Yeah. Which, which was like the tiny little hatchback that was like probably very poorly rated, and but it had the doors open, and so
that was my favorite. Nice. That was
so
it.
That allows.
I had one. I had, you know, I had a bunch of those, but one of my favorite little mini cars was a die-cast Corgi. Corgi had the license for the James Bond cars, so I had the one from Spy Who Loves Me, which is the underwater Lotus Esprit.
Oh, I thought it was like a dog.
No. So it was the at that point, I don't know who has the license now. So I remember because it was like a little submarine and the fins popped out.
Oh, fun.
And it was awesome. It was a little white Lotus.
Right. And then your imaginary little James Bond came out in the wetsuit and he had a full tuxedo underneath.
No, he never had a wetsuit because he was in the car. They went underwater and they came out. They never had a wetsuit in that particular one.
Okay.
Didn't have to have a wetsuit.
And I believe back in those days when he was in the wetsuit, they used to call, I think they called Frogmen. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
Frogmen. No. Okay. All right. Hey, before we wrap up, I just want to thank everybody for the very kind words. I had a very personal situation happen a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. My dog died, and I posted a note and a picture of she and I on Twitter, and I want to thank everybody. The outpouring was just, it was overwhelming. So you've heard me talk about my dog on this. She was 16 years old, and you've met her, Laura. Yes. And Jeff, I don't think you ever met my dog, did you?
No.
Yeah. So anyway, she was a delight, and unfortunately. Yeah. It always sucks. We're you know, I've always been an animal person. My sister's a veterinarian, so mm-hmm. Animals are in my life, and so it's just very nice to have that. So that's all. I know anybody who's gone through it understands it, and it sucks. But thank you for all your kind words. You guys are awesome. All right. Well, on that down note, can you bring us back up? Can you give me something to get us going here? Anything? Jeffrey?
I cannot be entertaining on demand. Larry.
I know. You can dance, monkey, dance!
on the spot is hard.
All right, gang. We'll talk to you guys later. Have a great time. We may be back next week. We may not. Graham may be here. He may not. Laura may be here. She may not.
Wait, Graham might be here?
I don't know. If he's on holiday, maybe he's going to be
here. You never
know.
Half the time he comes here.
Right. Exactly. Seems to be spending his holidays in America for some reason.
Yeah. It's like, you know how close you are to the French Riviera,
yeah,
Graham?
Yeah, exactly. Wrong way.
Yeah.
Or what's that party place? The
Ibiza?
Yes, Ibiza. That's it. You've been there, right? Younger Jeffrey's been there. All right.
Talk about those times.
All right. We'll talk to you guys. Thanks for downloading
the
show.
Listening.
Thank you. You can find us on Twitter and everywhere else. Jeffrey, you can find Jeffrey at?
At Jeff Rubenstein.
You can hit up Laura with her tips for getting her agents out of the jam
at Laura Lollipop.
I'm Major Nelson. You can find me here on the podcast on Twitter and every week this week on Xbox right on your console. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye.